Helen Aselli, one of the authors of Motivation and Learning Strategies for College Success, a focus on self-regulated learning that is now available in its sixth edition. Did you know that we as humans have a very limited capacity to process information at one single time? So let's talk about the human information processing system. As we look at the image, we see three sort of boxes that represent units in human information processing. So let's start from the left. From the left comes input from the world outside us, and it moves into the sensory memory or sensory register. Some things go immediately into memory loss, while some we may pay more attention to. If we pay attention to them, we move them into working memory. Multiple things can happen in working memory. We can keep things there. We can also start transferring things into long-term memory, or they may go into memory loss. And then finally, as you can see on the right hand there, is long-term memory. So that is the indefinite and infinite sort of store that we have for information. In order to move things into long-term memory, what we call encoding information, we really need to do something else with it. We need to elaborate on it. We need to organize it. So here's where we can talk about the difference and the importance of different learning strategies, rote versus meaningful learning. So let's take a look at some specific strategies. So the first one we see there is rehearsal, which is really just sort of repeating information. This could include copying material exactly as it is, note-taking, you know, verbatim taking notes of what the instructor says, or even one of the most popular learning strategies, which is underlining or highlighting text as it is. They are actually not very effective learning strategies. What is effective are the other two, elaboration and organization. So elaboration really means relating information to something we already know, such as note making. So comparing the new information with other pieces of information shared in a similar course. Summarizing information in our own words, not using the words of the author in the textbook or the professor, but using our own words, which means again, relating it to information that we already know. And the other strategy is organization, really organizing information in a meaningful manner, and it's essentially imposing structure on that on that information. And that could mean creating hierarchies, matrices, Venn diagrams, organizing it into, you know, the major ideas and the supporting details, et cetera, et cetera. So big differences in meaningful learning strategies and rote learning strategies. So we hope you've enjoyed this video about how to sort of address the limitations in our ability to process information at one single time. So don't forget to check out the book at routledge.com, and don't forget to come to the webinar about motivation and learning strategies on January 27th on 2020 to learn about meaningful strategies that can produce and facilitate meaningful long-term learning.